clay material is that it most likely comes from South Ray Crater and would not represent the local K-wave formation.
Right there. Look at it. Come through that rack. dispatch out of Houston. We'd like you to check your primary water valve and make sure it's open.
Okay, I'll let John check it. I'm feeling good. Nice and cool. Can you check it?
Yeah. Hey, man.
I'm not sure if it was all the way open.
Okay, Charlie, we think you're about to run out of primary seed water. Stand by for the tone. Just press on there.
Okay, already? Is that right?
That's affirmative.
What a man, come on. Okay, y'all been expecting it. All the way up is thin, isn't it, Houston?
Yeah.
Hey, man, I'm losing all of those. Yeah. About, there's three little ones.
Two little ones down. Hey, better get another one.
Coming back up again?
That's affirmative.
validated is the word I'm searching for.
Right, copy. Can you see where the TV is pointing?
Yes, it's pointed down towards South Ray.
Right, over to the right. Over to the right on the edge of clump there. It looks like there might be a rock with some phenocryst in it. If you're over that way, you might look around and see if you see something like that. It may have been just dust on it.
Okay, there's a big rock that I've already described. You get the acid there, John?
Yeah, I got the acid one.
Thank you. flag. There is a small crater, maybe 2 to 3 meters across. It's a real fridge. Has some real bright rays. You can see a blocky interior. Wait a minute, John.
Okay, 363.
Let me get an after set, Charlie.
Okay, I'm with you.
Have to get it notified.
317 at 51.
Okay, hit reset and watch the film. If it advances, we're through with it for now.
Oh boy, it advanced over 120, just black four. Almost 180.
Good job, that's the way it should go. Now we'd like you to turn around and look at the cosmic ray for a second.
Okay. The cosmic ray for a second. Turn around and look at the cosmic ray. Turn around and look at the cosmic ray. That's a nice cosmic ray.
Okay, in the top panel,
where's this look?
In the top panel, when you pull that red ring, a piece of tinfoil should have slid up so that there's only a 2x2 flap in the upper left-hand corner. Can you see that tinfoil?
There's only a 2x2 flap in the upper left-hand corner. Yeah, but it's more 2x2. It's about... And the hole is covered up. There's a hole up there. And it's covered up in the upper left-hand corner. They're almost covered up.
Okay, understand that. That should be right.
It's almost covered up.
Can you describe how it's almost covered up? Which part isn't covered?
The bottom part of the hole is almost uncovered. The bottom one fourth of the hole is not covered.
Okay, that's good news, John. That means you deployed fine. We'll get a picture of it later from Charlie, and if you could go about your normal work now.
The old water bag is working super. This is going to be a good day, Charlie. Good. The old commander's camera right down in the old duct. That's on the floor. That's on the floorboard. That's not under the ground. Okay. I wonder what my normal workload is at this point. I don't know. Supposed to be at stage four, John. Just like in training, John. I'm blinking the water to orange juice off my visor.
And Charlie, when you're taking that pad, let me know. I have another picture for you.
Alrighty. Okay, Charlie, hold still a second. Let me get your Just kidding, you guys. What we need is
less Velcro. Man, it's only yesterday with that piece of Velcro. Hey, can you guys see that dust on there with a TV?
We're not looking down far enough right now.
Don, make sure that I did draw all the things on. The ATP is empty. Magazine Lima is on the camera, 500. And all the other film is stowed. Okay, down and press back.
Okay.
Man, that LPM is a bucket of spaghetti.
I'm messing with it, are you?
No, I just was just... Okay, now there's an ice right here, Tony. What we gotta do now is load up the blisters and go get them. Do you want me to reset the far UV again, or you just want to be happy with this? All we gotta do now is a blip load up.
Okay, yes, we have one more target on it. I'm not sure they have enough time to hold on.
Hey, man, I gotta get a pan, John, so it'll be a few minutes. Why don't you run around and pick up a rock? Hey, outstanding suggestion. Give me a rock bag, Charlie. A little one to the big one. Why don't you take your camera?
I will. Yeah.
Okay, that's
yours, huh?
Yeah. Well, I got some right here. I'll just use those. And I'll, put the old maps. Which way are we going today?
How about south?
The Hadley Rill.
Okay.
This map has started training building.
Okay, verify that your PLIS antennas are up, and could we have an EMU check for 10? And Don, if you're out picking up a rock, you might
not have the comp.
Comp sounds good.
Maybe we ought to leave them down. That way we won't break them all.
And John, if you're picking up a rock, could you get that particular ball for the particular basalt underneath the engine bell?
Yep, sure could do that. Tony, that is a double muley, that rock.
Uh-oh.
Come here, John, let me get your antenna. Well, I can't reach it. Why don't you get down slope and lean on her rover? There we go. Camera's on, this is a... Guess what? Antenna's up and the comm's still the same. There we go.
And just forget that big rock for now. That's too big to handle.
Well, it's inaccessible. It's underneath the cover.
Okay, fine.
You want me to crawl under the lip?
No, that's all right.
Okay, but there's probably another nice rock. I'm sure there's another good rock around here. I've been eyeing out my window. I wanted to get anyway.
Birthday, it says. EDC, let's see.
there.
If you want some of this blackish rock, John, a small one, it's bangable. There's a bunch right out here. They look just like what I call that basalt. In fact, there's hundreds of them. Yeah, they're out from that little impact crater we just landed on. And I want to get this nice white one right here. Okay, the old pan. And it's up 11. That's 250.
Okay.
The best pan. Boy, it sure looked different looking up front. And you can still see those radiations in, Tony. In fact, they're maybe a little bit more pronounced.
Okay, do you feel like they're the same angle?
Yeah, exactly the same angle. Down at the bottom, they aren't any. They start in one place, that is. It's a little ridge. It's to the east of Cinco, down at the base. The one we call the base here. There's two pretty predominant craters over there. Right there, they aren't any.
Okay, why don't we cut that and drive out?
All over the mountain. Okay, I don't think we're going that far east, but...
Okay, those extra pictures...
Hey, Tony, what is the other picture?
Right, of the cosmic ray experiment. So if you'll go over to that side, we'd like a cross sun at a F11, 250, at 15 feet.
Okay, cross 9 F11, 250 and 15. Okay, Houston, I just picked up this rock. It's a white rock, very white rock, but it has a black blast layer on the back of it, or what appears to be black blast. A thick black blast, and it's about a hand-sized specimen. I can't get it in a bag, but I'll get it anyway. It has a lot of zap craters in it and some... finding the zap craters or some whitey substance.
Okay, done. Sounds good. And Charlie, we'd like an up sun of that cosmic ray also. And the settings on that will be F5.6.
Okay, looking up sun. Okay. Then you know that thing's not even looking at the sun, is that right? Is that what you want it to do?
That's right. We want it to look away from the sun.
Okay, that's what it is. I don't think you're going to see much in this picture, but I'll take it. It's, I guess it's just really going to show you just how it's sitting. Okay, that's done.
Okay, good show. And we'll have the UV after the flip loadout. That's it, Charlie.
Clean a little bit of spaghetti here. Charlie, don't get too close to that. Watch out for the battery cable. I see that. It just says over deploy cable. I was in. There. I'm okay. Okay, we're ready for the load up, and I'll swap cameras with you. Put yours on your seat, John. Don't let those bags go that you had. You got them? I put them over there on my back. There you go, Charlie. Just leave it there. Where? Okay, why don't you put those on my camera and I'll put these on yours, okay? I got two core tubes sitting up there, too. Don't let me forget those. Where, up on the thing? Yep, on the hand tool carrier. Do you want them in this building? No, they go back in here. What are we going to do with this FCB right now? That one goes under my... That one I'm throwing on my back. That's the one I emptied yesterday.
Okay, fine.
And, I get that. The other one... He's going to be chock full of core tubes today, babe. I'll tell you. This is core tube taking day. And a super empty... Whatever.
off, I guess.
Okay, hold still.
Excuse me.
That ain't good for him tonight.
Ah, the old lunar surface. We really kicked this stuff up, Tony, right around the lunar module where we walk at, where you don't have the footprints and the tracks. It's very smooth, very white albedo.
Could you bend over?
Yeah, very white albedo. Where we've kicked it up, it's about two shades grayer. It's a dark, lot darker albedo. And you know why I think that is, Tony? You look down, son, and it's not that way. You look up, son. And it is. I think it's the shadows that the sun cast on the particles that have been disturbed. It causes it to give a darker albedo.
Good observation. Hey, Charlie, that's it.
Okay, your turn. Then you'll be able to carry this thing for core tubes in it.
That worked.
I couldn't get it off a minute ago, man. There we go.
I'll just lay those things on to take it. Double.
Frameship drive charging.
Houston, it's easier on the moon to,
Thank you.
at Stone Mountain. Is that what you want?
I'll find out, John. That 276 and 14 are the targets.
Okay, stand by. Okay, there were those mounds mapped over in Phantom area. Can you see those?
Both of the rocks are angular to sub-round it.
Okay, do you feel you're still in that ray?
Still in this ray.
I am. Just covered with blocks and holes, Houston.
Okay, we copy.
Lots of secondary, Tony.
Charlie, what are we shooting for?
Well, we're supposed to be 150.
The brake plate to keep this mast right wedged in that camera.
Yeah. Woo! Man, that's a great big skid. We're doing 10 clicks, Tony.
Outstanding.
Still down about a 2 to 3 degree slope now. Oh, Barney's really driving this thing.
There sure are a lot of rocks.
Still, as we described, cobbling. Cobble size is still the same. Maybe 10% of the surface now. Hey, now, Tony. Still in indurated secondaries.
Okay, you should be about halfway to survey.
Okay. Slowing down to about 6 clicks.
Go.
That's gonna be a steep slope up there, John.
I believe it is, Charlie.
Up stone. Okay, we're looking for 3.48. And the percentages are just exactly the same. Characteristics of the regolith are identical. And it still appears loosely compact. Almost like a freshly plowed field with that's been rained on.
Okay, we understand that.
Stubby. Hey, we're coming up to the biggest rock now we've passed on a traverse. Click. Got a picture of it. And it looks like a bridge also, Tony. It was rounded. Center of the surface is covered.
French
with
charging.
Cobbles up to 15 to make it 30 centimeters. With the largest block being the meter size. Back down in almost, we dropped maybe 20 meters, just past Mary that's 10 meters across.
Okay, you should see Mary over to your right.
The dome of Pohol, the hummocks are,
what's your ASP down here now, Charlie?
Okay, we still gotta go three, this is the one is two from here, up over is,
168.
7 for 4 tenths, we should be at 005 at 180.
This is terrible, it's raining, isn't it?
Yep, that's why I want to get out of it.
Yeah. Okay, we must be coming to the edge of it. My estimate of the cobbles is back down to about 20% now.
Boy, it is something. It's really something.
You're still going 8 clicks though, John. We're right on. Hey, Tony, apparently we're still on survey. It's a bright fourth. And the thing goes right to the right of that. Apparently. In fact, that big one is probably Cinco E.
From where you are, Cinco should be right in line with the ground.
It is, Tony. Right now, we got it spotted.
Okay.
Really, until we hit and start climbing upslope at Station 6.
Houston, the best idea I can give you of what this looks like is it looks like about halfway up to that crater that we went to out at the Nevada test site. Man, I tell you, I've never seen so many blocks in my life.
Okay, sounds like that.
Okay, now between us and the survey, Tony, we really drop off again down to the base of stone. We're going down about a 4 or 5 degree slope that's still apparently ejecta blast in them.
Okay, what's the bearing and range for that, getting off the contact?
Done, yes. Okay, we'll give it to you. We're right now at 354 at 2.5. We're still in a block field.
Regular.
Okay, you got it, babe, and I think that's a pretty good guess. As far as, at least that's where the slope of stone starts. That stone mountain looked like it was right on top of us. We've come 2.6 kilometers. Good shape, hardly fractured. Others appear to be badly fractured, but still homogeneous.
Your description, it sounds like we won't have any trouble finding split boulders at 8.
That's it, great. 8 clicks, Tony. We got up to 12 there, one. We're at 355 at 2.8. Still have Crown and Cinco E in sight.
Sounds like you're really making money there.
And we got a... That poop about being able to see the limb all the way on Traverse 2, I think, was going to be bumped up. We've come down to some big swales.
Okay.
They may call them swales in your part of the world, Charlie. They call them mountains in mine.
Yep. Okay, and...
Okay.
Okay, you're looking right at
about a 10 degree slope now.
Okay.
And let's see, 6 was at
000
at,
Charlie, what should we be heading for?
Those craters up there.
I'm gonna tell me that.
Okay, see that one? It's sort of a funny shape, looks like it's got a breach in the southeast side at 12 o'clock.
Yeah.
That's it.
The one at 12 o'clock, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, Houston, now that we get up to Stone Mountain, what's that one is?
Worse
than what we've been driving down.
I think this is one of our bitches here, John.
I think it is.
Yeah, we're at 3-3, and 5 should be at 3-3. And, okay, Tony, we're on a flat area now at 355 and 3.3. And I think it apparently is a bitch. It's about, we're passing station 5, a little to the east.
Okay, glad you can recognize it there. That's great.
And it's, I'll tell you, it's just as blocky here. The black population is up again to about 40 to 50%.
Okay, you might look for a fresh crater that would punch through that ray material in the, Descartes. For station 5 when you come back.
No, we got lots of... Okay, most of the craters here are, there's another split one, but
it's... Look at those South Ray, Charlie.
That's beautiful. Just spectacular. I can't believe it. And there's Baby Ray, John.
Yeah?
Yeah, you can see it. It's got black sides to it. Okay, here's the crater, Tony. Remember, this is 354 at 3.4. It's about 15 meters across and about 5 meters deep, and I bet you it punched through.
Oh, man, this...
Okay, we'll keep that in mind.
That should be a good station 5.
Okay.
Man, we are really going up a hill, I'll tell you.
Frameship
drive, charging. I don't want to see it recognized.
Okay, see there, it looks like a bench or a little ridge on top. Okay, we're at 354 and 3.6.
4, 3, 2, 1.
And you ought to see that baby thing. It's got a real good raised rim. You can see some good, it's got lots of blocks around it that are hard to estimate the size. And we're going up a steep, steep hole, John. I'll tell you.
We believe you, Charlie.
Okay, our amps are now up to 60.
Oh, wait a minute, that's low. Yeah, Charlie.
This is gonna be spectacular. I can see wreck and trap and orange juice. Golly. There's a little bench on up there, a little bit more, John.
Yeah, we're getting up on a bench right now.
And boy, this is going to be such a spectacular view. You can't believe it. Okay, we're at Cinco, Tony. We feel at 3.7 at 355.
See it anywhere, Charlie?
What? Cinco? Yeah, this is it. Here's the one. There's one. And the big one is just to the left over there with the V in it.
Charlie, you're probably at one of the lower Cincos, not D or E. You should have something like 4.0.
Okay, we'll go. Okay, we'll go on up.
A little easier driving uphill and down.
And you're well ahead on the timeline. You've been making good time.
Tony, I can see into
Charlie, let's go up here to this big blocky crater, man. That's really good.
Where's that?
That might be.
I don't think I'm gonna be able to see Stubby from.
You see it from here?
Yeah, I can see it.
about 60 feet above the planned stopping point.
We're in a pretty good right roll, Tony. About 5 to 10 degrees right roll and climbing up a steep slope. Great bench right up here. So it might be a crater just right in front of us, about 20 meters. Why don't we stop there?
Right up there, you
mean? I'm talking about right, just really right here. See this big block at about 1 o'clock at 12:30?
Right here?
Yeah, right here.
Okay, we concur with whatever blocky crater you want to stop at up there.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay,
super. And Tony, I think we're up at just about the crown crater.
Okay. The main thing is to make sure we have a crater that's big enough that punches through any ray material from South Ray.
This one does. Don't worry. This is a 10-meter crater. It's got blocks on the inside of it that are partially covered with fillet material.
Okay.
And that's at 354 and 4.0.
Hey, John, how about hooking left? Don't wait for, hey, this is going to be pretty good. Man, I think we're going to be surprised. Look at those blocks, John.
All right, we think you're one of the sharp Zinkos.
Boy. We think you're
a sharp Zinko. I do, too. Hey, can we get up there closer to end up right in that block, John?
One, the part of wall.
Upslope. Seems to be a flat place about right up here. Yeah.
It's almost flat.
But, well, according to the pitch meter, it's not as pegged out.
Hey, fellas, Ken was just flying over and he saw a flash on the side of their car. He probably got a glint off you.
Yep. That's us. Man, those mirrors are dusty.
I'm up here and set it in a crater so it doesn't go anywhere. This looks pretty good. I don't think it's going to go down slow.
Tony, you can't blame it. This view looking back to the east. We see ravines. We see the rim of North Ray that's got some really good blocks on it.
Look at this slope. Look what we've been coming up. Man.
And, but we cannot see into North Ray. It's above our position.
Okay.
And we can see the whole lunar module. Look at that, John.
Okay, 270 on the heading. Okay, Charlie, I don't want to go back down there and park in that flat, in that crater right there.
Okay.
What I'm saying?
Yeah, okay. Looks like to me, from my side, if you just turn real sharp left, you'd have it. But that's fine with me.
But it's not flat, Charlie. It's pointing to downhill.
Well, not sideways, it would be.
Huh?
Sideways? We got to park to 70. But that'd be fine. If you, why don't you go down there, John? You probably would. That big rock.
You cleared it.
Which one you gonna park in?
That one right down there with that block in it.
The right?
Yep.
Okay.
200.
Okay, starting with the 500. I'm going to intermediate. I mean, mid.
Position on the Kuma.
Okay, it does.
Tony, you can see the rays of south rays come out across the landscape. I think we need to dust the TV lens. It's pretty dusty.
Yeah, Charlie, if you get a chance, I would like a dusty.
Brush.
Yeah, it looks really dusty, Tony. Just a minute.
Okay, these blocks we see lying around the surface, are most of them sharp ray?
Boy, I tell you, Tony, up these, I just came up about a 20-degree slope, and it is really loosely compacted here. Stand by, I'm gonna swing the big eye around. I can't dust with unless I do that.
Okay, Houston, I've got a hard rock. I think it's glass-coated, but it's so dust-covered I can't tell. And it's going in bag 394.
Okay, 394. Okay.
Okay, that's going in the back 395.
I don't get this much of your brain smell.
I don't either.
But it's just depression. Pulled it out and it came out like it was supposed to, and then I started moving the thing down and it fell off.
Okay, John.
going to follow our footsteps back.
Okay? Good idea.
Tony, did you read?
Yeah, we sure did.
Well,
okay, we're looking at
where we're underway.
And we're looking at a few changes there, Spook. We're going to cut that station down to about 19 minutes. And if you get there in time, we'll have John go ahead down his nominal through the LPM, then we'll end at the LPM tight measurement. And Charlie, you can do your 500 millimeter near the edge of Spook and do a pass near the rim of Spook and run over and do a couple of samples of Buster if you have time left. That'll be station two.
Okay, Wanda, cut back.
Okay, it's your water consumption there, Charlie.
All right.
That's all right. You're getting some really good geology there. Don't feel bad.
Okay, we're making good time going back, and it's easier looking going up, son. You can see the craters a lot better. The regolith, the characteristics of the regolith are the same.
Are you using the 16, Charlie?
No.
Well, it ain't easier for me. I don't follow these tracks and be bad. Up, son, or down, son, it's bad for driving.
Alright, we figured it probably would be.
Well, you make it great time, John. We're doing 11 clicks.
Outstanding.
Super.
The Grand Prix driver done it again.
Barney Oldfield.
I can follow a road.
Back to the on-off switch mode. John, did you duck that TV last?
I ducked it somewhere.
Okay, fine.
I don't remember if it's that station or not.
Okay, I guess we'll need a duck to get at this next stop.
Alrighty.
Okay, Tony, as I look up sun here, going back through the... you can see these lineations. Mostly furrows, I'd call them, with random orientation. And they're definitely the sun casting shadows into unconsolidated regolith.
Right.
Frameshift drive charging.
You can't believe how up and down this is, Tony.
How about when you drive across rays? Do you notice any difference in the rover track?
A mile, that's gotta be it,
Okay, spooks are looking about the same size as flag.
Not that, does it look the same size?
No, this is the biggest crater right over here to the right.
Okay, well, this is Buster.
Okay, that's what I thought. It's a blocking crater.
Let's stop the rover halfway between us.
Yeah.
No, near the edge of spooks.
It's a lot bigger than, yeah. Okay, it's about, 2 meters or so. We're bearing a 089er for point eight.
Okay.
We're supposed to park 180 about halfway, John. Go clear the big hole back over here, can you?
Right, a little bit near the edge of spook so we can see into spook.
What you really want to see into is Buster.
Okay.
Buster is about the same size as, it's what we call spook here. In fact, it's a more impressive crater.
Okay, whatever turns you on there.
John, that's gotta be. Tony, is there big craters to the south of, Spook?
Cold, man.
It'd be quite a way. Red Rose is, looks like about 8 tenths of a kilometer.
Okay, well, let's park here, John. This is great sampling. We got plenty of boulders and everything.
All right, let's do it right here. We concur.
But Buster is a lot bigger than Plum is. It's the one we call Plum.
Right, it should be.
It sure is.
Okay. Well, we got in the right place then, if it should be. Okay, we're stopped and we're 180, 087, 2.8, 115, 115, 72, 72, 100, 100, off scale low, off scale low.
Okay, we copy.
Okay, Tony, under here, again, right under the regolith, the first centimeter or so, we have the white albedo material.
Understand. Hey, that does a good job on the lens there.
Your eye looks clear to me there.
Yeah, that helps a lot.
And the Earth is be locked up.
Yeah.
The Earth is more sighted in the more sighted.
Tony, I've already emptied SCB-1 in there.
Good deal.
Okay, Tony, like we planned, I'm just into that.
Okay.
And it packs easier that way.
Elevation 20.
26.
Yeah. battery unlocked down at the bottom, but it won't unlock up at the top. Which way do I push it or pull it?
It should be a liftoff. Straight up. Correct. Straight out. Charlie, was your magazine Bravo or Golf?
Tony.
Aim to help.
Dangling too. Can you bend over, John? Yes, got it.
Okay, I've placed the course in. That's Ford SRC, HCC, Commander and Load, SCB, close SRC 1, Mesa Blanket, Big Rock, ready for the Queen EMU.
You can pick the right extent, Charlie.
Thank you.
this roll.
Can you feel that water running through your hose right there, John?
And right feeling.
Oh, God.
Drop the brush.
Drop the brush.
Get it.
Thank you.
dust bag out.
No, we understand. Just get a lot of dust around the cabin and that open rock.